Good evening. I am Pastor Cara and Maeda, and I want to welcome you to Hilo Coast United Church of Christ. Tonight, we welcome and celebrate the glorious birth of Jesus Christ. This service is an opportunity for us to step away from the excitement, the preparations, and the additional festivities, and to spend a few moments in worship and reflection. At the end of the service, we will have a time to light a candle, and I invite you to have a candle for each of you or one for your whole family. You may pause the video now to gather any supplies that are needed. Oh, and don't forget a lighter. Let us open our time in prayer. God of hope and love, we praise you for the light that has been brought into our world through Jesus Christ. And we thank you for the many ways we can celebrate Jesus' birth. As we enter into this time of worship, settle our hearts and minds. Help us to set aside the things that need to be done or the distractions around us so that we can spend these moments being in your presence. Refresh us and remind us that you are with us. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. This service is a time for you to be in the presence of God. So I welcome you to make this your own. We will have a couple of songs with lyrics on the screen, and you are welcome to sing along or simply enjoy the music and words. However way you choose, may this be a worshipful time, centering our focus on Christ.
Thank you.
Throughout our Advent journey, we have lit a candle each week. We lit the candle of hope. We lit the candle of peace. We lit the candle of joy. And we lit the candle of love. And tonight, we light the Christ candle. As we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, we remember that light has come into the world. John chapter 1 says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." Jesus is the light for all people. Tonight, we center our focus on Christ. Let us pray. For the light that you brought into the world, and for the light you shine in our lives, we praise you, O God. Thank you for being the source that offers life for all people. Amen. Tonight's scripture reading is from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. Hear now the word of God. "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. For as in the day of Midian's defeat, you have shattered the yoke that burdens them, the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. Every warrior's boot used in battle, and every garment rolled in blood will be destined for burning, will be fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born. To us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. Thanks be to God for the blessing of Scripture in our lives. Amen. This passage was first given as a beacon of hope to a people who were experiencing exile, destruction, and war. They were in need of light as they walked in times of darkness. Then here, the prophet Isaiah says the words of God, saying, "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned." What words of hope and peace when all seems lost. This light that has dawned is one that would transform the structures of oppression and offer freedom through justice and righteousness. There would once again be peace because of a child born, a son given who will take the burden of authority. And this child, as the scripture says, is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. These words offer hope, a hope the people could hold on to until the birth of the Messiah, Jesus. Jesus is the light that shines in the darkness, and he is not overcome by the darkness. For the people in Isaiah's time, they knew that a light will shine in the darkness, that a child will be born, and who that child will be as the Messiah. But now that we are on the other side of Jesus' birth and life, we know that nothing, not even death, can overcome Jesus. This is the hope we have, knowing who Jesus is as the Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace, and the light that shines in the darkness. Through Jesus, there is light in this world, and that is what we focus on tonight. As we prepare to light our own candles, think about where the light of Christ is needed in your own life. Where does light need to shine? Who is on your mind that is in need of light? What places are upon your hearts? For you, the light of Christ shines. For the people in your life, the light of Christ shines. For the places experiencing darkness, the light of Christ shines. I invite you to take your candle and to light it. And as you do, allow the light of Christ to shine in your life. Also, offer a prayer for the people and places that are in need of this light. Tonight, we remember that Jesus is love's pure light, with radiant beams flowing into every corner. Let the light of the candle radiate around you, offering reminders of hope and peace, knowing that the light will always be greater than the darkness. Let us focus on the light of Christ as we sing together, Silent Night, Holy Night. On this holy night, we remember a gift of light given in grace. This is a gift that comes with peace and hope. It comes with joy as our strength, and it is a gift that is wrapped in love. May the light of Christ continue to shine brightly as you enjoy the sights, the sounds, and the tastes of Christmas. Light has come into the world. Christ is born. Merry Christmas.